doing business in Africa. You can't afford to be without Africa Investor.
Good day and welcome on behalf of Africa Investor to the second AI Africa PLC ICC Global eTrade Leaders Summit on the African Continental Free Trade Area, which follows yesterday's historic African Union Heads of State Extraordinary Summit on the African Continental Free Trade Area. My name is Hubert Danso. I am the Chairman of Africa Investor and the Chairman of the African Union's Continental Business Network, and I will chair this summit held in partnership with the ICC and supported by the African Continental Free Trade Area at Secretariat. I would first like to thank each of you present for making the time on a Sunday for this second AI Africa PLC ICC Global eTrade Leaders Summit. By way of background, the first summit focused on how we could respond to COVID-19 through eTrade and collaboration with the African Continental Free Trade Area in March. And this happened right at the onset, where we convened and tasked the Secretary Generals of the International Chamber of Commerce, Bern Union, the African Union Continental Free Trade Area Secretariat, the World Customs Organization, and the World Trade Organization to collaborate and champion eTrade SME-supportive COVID-19 response initiatives ahead of the launch of the African Continental Free Trade Area on the 1st of January 2021. This second summit has reconvened the key Secretary Generals, business leaders, heads of chambers of commerce from across Africa, SMEs and tech investors on the margins of yesterday's African Union Heads of State Summit to fulfill that undertaking. Yesterday, the African Union Heads of State unequivocally delivered an important milestone to cement and advance the implementation of the African Continental Free Trade Area. And today, within 24 hours of the Heads of State Summit decision, we are convening here today as African and global business to reciprocate support through concrete private sector-led implementation initiatives and platforms, and to repledge the private sector's continued partnership and support to the implementation and growth of the African Continental Free Trade Area. Colleagues, in that spirit, we have three core objectives for this summit. Firstly, to launch the Africa PLC Industrial eTrade and Fintech platform to support African SMEs trade digitally across the African Continental Free Trade Area and globally. Secondly, to launch the ICC AI Africa PLC Digitise 5 Million SMEs initiative, which is building on and building and empowering a powerful community of African SMEs that are supporting the African Continental Free Trade Area. And thirdly, to restate the African and global business communities and Chamber of Commerce Network's commitment to supporting the implementation of the African Continental Free Trade Area at both a digital trade policy and global and Pan-African market access level. I think one of the statistics that we've heard recently is that, you know, as a continent, we used to actually be around 6% of global trade, and we were ahead of Asia in terms of share of global trade. And we're now behind Asia at around 2-3%, and Asia is ahead of us. And we are going to be working very hard through the African Continental Free Trade Area and all the opportunities that it represents to certainly not only increase our intra-African trade, but also reverse and increase significantly our share of global trade. You know, as has been made very clear to us, the African Continental Free Trade Area, in many respects, is our COVID-19 stimulus platform. And we as the private sector cannot discriminate or leave any commercial trading partner or opportunity out. Rapid industrialization and increasing market share of intra-African trade market is an absolute priority, and digital initiatives are key to achieving this. Acting with urgency to seize the opportunity to invest in redesigning our supply chain networks, practices, and trade policies for a new, modern, and industrially value addition-focused African trading system under the African Continental Free Trade Area is an opportunity we will rise to. And we're going to do that by mobilizing the anchor investment from African pension and sovereign wealth funds for the industrial trade-related supply chain infrastructure needed for us, not for the historic reasons that it was constellated for raw materials, but for us to be able to supply finished goods and value-added goods into the global market. And therefore, collaborating with global partners like the ICC through its worldwide and authoritative trade policy organs and mandate to share global best e-trade policy practice and identify and address market access barriers to African goods and services into global markets is a key part of our particular partnership. Innovative partnerships and collaboration with the private sector and the international organizations will be critical to bring this all together. This is why I'm delighted to have partnered with the ICC and the World Business Organization on this particular event. Just to quickly introduce our key high-level speakers today, we have His Excellency Wamkele Meni, who is the Secretary General of the African Continental Free Trade Area Secretariat. We have John Denton, who is the Secretary General of the International Chamber of Commerce. We have Kunio Mukuria, who is the Secretary General of the World Customs Organization. We have Vinko David, who is the Secretary General of the Bern Union. We have Valentina Minter, who is an executive board member of the ICC's global board. And we have Maynard Oosthuizen, who is the Chief of Operations at Africa PLC.
Doing business in Africa. You can't afford to be without Africa Investor.